Serge was a very good athlete, very agile, and big and strong.
Any winger having to match up with him night after night or over the course of the night, very discouraging.
You just couldn't score on him. When Savard is on the ice, he is impossible.
I've talked to some players of his era, say he's the best defenseman he ever played against.
In the 1970s, Serge Savard anchored the defense of a Montreal Canadiens team that became one of the NHL's greatest dynasties. It was a storybook career for the Quebec native, who grew up in a village 400 miles north of Montreal.
My first contact was really listening to games on the radio. Being a French-Canadian, our dream was to play for the Montreal Canadiens.
Savard made his first appearance with the Canadiens at age 20. He was fast and strong and exceptionally big.
When I was younger, I played center. My first training camp, I was 6'3", 215. They look at me and it's too big to play forward. We have to play you on defense.
The Canadiens won the Stanley Cup in Savard's first full season, 1967-68. And by the following season, Savard had become one of the team's most important players.
Savard breaks it up at the blue line and has Glenn Hall at his mercy.
In the playoffs that year, he had 4 goals and 6 assists and won the Conn Smythe Trophy as the Canadiens swept the St. Louis Blues to win their second straight Stanley Cup.
It was big. All of a sudden, overnight, you're a big hero.
Provo to Savard, and Savard makes no mistake.
A budding two-way star, Savard was forced to change his style after breaking his leg in 5 places in 1970, and then breaking it again the following season.
I became more of a defensive defenseman. I didn't take as many chances.
As Savard became more of a stay-at-home defenseman, fellow blue liners Guy Lapointe and Larry Robinson were free to gamble more. It was a winning formula, to say the least. Starting in 1973, the Big Three, as the trio became known, won 5 Stanley Cups, including 4 straight from 1976 to 1979.
Individually, they were all great talents, but all put together. I mean, that's why the Canadiens were such a tremendous force.
What is lost was how much time Serge Savard played on the ice. We got into the last 5 minutes of the game, Serge never went off the ice.
Oh, tremendous save by Savard!
He made the game look so easy. He appeared not to work very hard on the ice, and yet the puck was always in the right place. The puck was always out of the zone.
In his last Stanley Cup final in 1979, Savard showed he could still shine on the biggest stage. It was overtime in Game 4 on the road.
Montreal hits the crossbar. Savard turns to Davidson, the goaltender for the New York Rangers, and says, I'll be back.
LaFleur racing after him.
Goes back down the ice 5 minutes later, scores.
LaFleur check, here's Savard. Shoots, he scores! Savard!
The Canadiens won the series in 5 games, and Savard hoisted his 8th Stanley Cup. Savard played 4 more seasons, including 2 in Winnipeg. Before retiring as a player and returning to Montreal to become general manager. He picked up where he left off with the Canadiens, winning the Stanley Cup in 1986 and again in 1993 for an astounding 10 Cups overall.
Some of the players played the league many, many years and never touched the Stanley Cup. I was lucky enough to play for the Montreal Canadiens. That was the dream come true.